hate puppies.
Good podcast.
I feel threatened.
Seriously, be real.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Inside the Pallet House.
Classic Stew.
Glad to be back in the Pallet House. Only podcast dedicated to solving first world problems and hopefully you figuring out what you should be drinking next week. I bought a special beer this week because I thought, oh yeah, Ely's here. This beer might be the perfect blend of what he's looking for and what he's not looking for. Let's do a challenge. Ely, what's your take? He did not make it this
Crickets.
Week. Funny thing is, he was on his way, which is literally why I bought the beer that we tried.
Oh, by the way, I showed up last week and you weren't here, dude.
Awkward.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. I feel. I don't want to dog Ely. The dude literally had car troubles.
Well, I know a car guy, so
Ely.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's my car guy.
No, and he's literally waiting on the stuff right now. So
with a Honda, his Honda wouldn't start. Anyone ever heard that before? Like, that's not a take.
No shit.
That sounds like he just didn't want to hang out.
Yeah.
But are we going to have to jump him if he gets here and wants to leave?
We're going
to
beat him in.
Just hiding behind the doors when he comes.
No shit. Let's jump him in.
I brought this sock full of quarters for a reason.
For something.
Yeah.
For something.
Swinging around all afternoon.
That's right.
So, yeah, unfortunately, he's not
my
here.
Sock I thought, swinging arm
going? I really thought I had a winner for him. Thought I had a winner. I saw it and I was like, oh, I've got it.
Well, I'm excited. Does that mean anything to you?
But you're not.
Well, that's true.
That's the truth. You still sober, Troy?
Still sober.
Nice.
How long has this been? Do we have a number or we stop counting?
6.5 weeks.
That's an impressive run. Can we talk not about bad. My 2 weeks?
Your 11 days?
Hey, you got over double digits.
Hey, I did talk to... Who did I talk to the other day? I talked to somebody, and they were like, yeah, Brendan went off the sauce for a while, huh? And I was like,
yep.
Yeah, it was 11 days, and they were like, that's still pretty good for Brendan. I was like, yeah, you got to give it to him.
I'll take what I
you
can get.
You do have to give it to
yeah.
him.
I'll take what I can
well,
get.
He's going to take it even if you exactly. don't give it to him.
What's your definition of a while?
11 days.
11 days.
We now have scientific definition of
4 score and 7 years.
Yeah.
Or 11 days.
It's science.
You run the numbers how you choose. 6.5 weeks.
Yeah.
Not missing it.
Nope.
Proud of you, man.
Yeah. Good stuff.
That's dope.
Sleeping better?
No. I'm old.
Yeah. Well, speaking of drinks or drinking, someone introduced a drink to me the other day that's called Diesel.
Diesel?
And, yeah.
What's that?
So it is Fireball. So if you take a rocks glass or even a solo cup, it's 1/4 Fireball and the rest 3/4 Blue Frost Gatorade.
That sounds
Fireball
like a blast.
Blue Frost Gatorade.
Yeah, and it was pretty interesting.
So, where did you have this?
It was at a buddy's house the other day.
Just so, you know, home bar setup.
Yeah, just he's like, I saw this
Fireball and blue. So you're hydrating and dehydrating at the same time.
This sounds straight
but it's a mixed
out of
drink. It's
like
a mixed drink.
College apartment party.
No, you mix it or later.
He saw it. There was a clip, and we made it, and it was actually I was very surprised.
I saw it on TikTok.
You're too old to drink that shit.
Well,
I
don't like Fireball to begin with, but
so
it
don't
wasn't,
drink it. You don't have
loves,
to drink things you don't like. You're
loves
an adult.
Gatorade. Loves.
I do love Frost.
Big
Blue Frost,
Gatorade.
Blue Frost,
guy.
I love Gatorade. Blue Frost Gatorade. I think it's, but the problem is it doesn't fuck me up.
Gatorade?
Yeah.
You know what you should put in it?
What?
Fireball.
Yeah! I'm back in.
Boom.
We got a winner.
This is brilliant.
Oh, no. This actually is on TikTok.
Of course it's on TikTok.
Of course it's a TikTok. Have you seen their new ad where they're saying it's like hashtag I learned it on TikTok?
That's what I was just saying. It's
they're trying to... Sorry, I was plugging in the board.
That was a shocking little moment.
They're trying to like make TikTok like it's a learning platform, which obviously people learn that. I'm not on there. I only get sent stupid ones, so I'm assuming.
I didn't know how to twerk till TikTok. And now my ass... bounces.
You got it down.
I'm like Megan Thee Stallion.
Brendan the Stallion.
I may be incorrect, but
Brendan the Pony.
But I thought I saw something where TikTok was outreaching searches.
Oh, it
than
is.
Than Google.
Yeah. It's outreaching
like just
everything else. Oh, ridiculous. I heard a thing that said people watch more TikTok than YouTube now.
Hmm. Well, it's because of the short platform.
Yeah. In your point about the learning platform, are they trying to take like YouTube's market share in that
regard?
Like,
yeah.
Trying to just say like, hey, I want to teach people how to do stuff in shorter bits rather than watching Joe make something on
which instead of learning fully how to do it.
Exactly.
Let me learn the 15.
I want the shortcut,
I want the Cliff Notes version.
Which would explain why Apple.
Can I rebuild this engine in 15 seconds?
Yeah. You got to change the radiator. Oh, TikTok made it seem easy.
What do you mean you got to turn the car off?
You want me to go to school for
righty
how long?
Righty-tighty, lefty-loosey, Brendan.
Thanks, Healy.
No, but that would explain why Apple and Google are trying to deplatform them as far as being able to upload the apps for, I think that's what I saw.
I think they have more of a security concern than.
Well, yes, I know that too.
Don't poke the bear, though. You know what I mean? Like, if everybody's you don't poke those bears.
I love China. What are you guys talking about?
Do they still make up a good portion of the listenership?
It's always a small portion, but this is always my favorite experiment. Now that we've mentioned China once, now twice.
Oh,
who do we mention?
I find that you have to talk about the People's Republic of China about
there's a magic
five
number.
Times. Yeah, and after about five times, their little crawlers, like, they're Wait, talking about China. Yeah.
All right, we got to listen in real quick.
Yeah.
The many times I've gone there on vacation.
Spreading the good word of Christianity as we go.
Oh, here's where you really fuck them up. What you're doing to the Uyghurs is genocide.
Oh, no.
Boom. Now, you see, this
don't
is
put that. Look, if Boo Boo can find your house, don't you think China can?
Yeah.
Bro, I buy their drones. I put them in the house. Not only that, I fly them
from inside the house right now.
Yeah, I fly them in the house. I fly them outside of the house. They know which room. They know where the bidet is. They're like, it's 10 a.m.
They made it.
Yeah. No, that's Japanese. Racist. It's a Toto.
Keep it up. You're going to get an email from China that says, hey, you want to work for us?
Yeah. We need more.
We could use a guy just like you.
Dude, I'll tell you what, man. Like, this goes right along with that LIV tour. Like, my price, China, is probably not as high as you think. It's not as high as Phil Mickelson's. I'll tell you
Oh, God.
Not to really work with China. That's crazy. But I would go on that LIV tour. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, man.
And it would take tens of dollars.
Dozens of dollars.
Just push me over the edge.
Speaking of Mickelson, Tiger blew up today. Was opening round at the British Open.
Well, when this comes out tomorrow, that'll be old news.
The whole thing about the LIV Tour is, like, you know the money's dirty. And you're kind of dicking over the PGA because you wouldn't be rich and famous already if it wasn't for the PGA.
Yeah.
Every gallon of gas you pump, you agree to the atrocities they've done.
Do I have a choice? Do those guys have
electric
more
cars.
Of a choice than I do?
Clearly.
Okay.
Saying we're all on our high horse, but like we don't all have electric cars on any kind
so
of
So you're
atrocities.
Saying the so putting a gallon of fuel in my car is the equivalent of making $200 million.
I fucking wish it was because I put
you just did.
Gallons
you just said
car.
I'm the same as these guys.
You well, I was. It was a reach. Boat. It was a reach, Troy.
You think?
Thanks for calling me out, Troy.
Well, I'd gladly buy my fuel elsewhere if I had a choice.
If there was a gas station that said American gas, and it was 10 cents more a gallon, and it was right next to a place 10 cents less that you knew was Saudi gas, would
I would.
Go?
I would definitely.
I think I might
for 20 because I have a 20-gallon tank. Like that's like $8. I don't know, Matt, but yeah, it's not that much.
Serious? No. It's $2.
Yeah, it's $2. Like, I wouldn't care about paying $2 extra for a tank of gas, which is funny because when I was a kid and gas was $2.99 a gallon, like I would drive 4 miles out of the way to save 3 cents on a gallon of gas. Like now I look back, I'm like, that was just a waste of my damn time.
There is money to be made. Open American gas.
Even if it's not. Just put them in.
No, that's fucked. No, you got to.
Isn't it like
that.
Murphy USA that has all the red, white, and blue banners at those gas stations?
There you go.
But Marathon.
But you know their gas isn't
100%.
Like, no chance. I'm saying, like, we only use American gas.
We just start refining our own gas and just selling American gas?
And moonshine.
There you go.
Well, and they're actually interchangeable.
Take it back to our roots.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you do ethanol, you can work with that.
You can fill up your NASCAR here and drive your moonshine in the back of it. Let's go.
In this day and age, I think that shit would fly. I need to raise some capital.
No, you know what would happen? That place would be picketed and burned to the fucking ground before it even opened up.
The American one?
Yes.
Probably.
By whom?
Most Americans don't like America, if you haven't figured that one out yet.
I am still very much on the pro-America train. I didn't realize...
I'm with you.
I didn't realize there was an anti-America sentiment. I thought we were all saying how much we love America by hating on other Americans. I thought that was what was the most American thing to do. I look at you and go, your American views are fucked. Fuck you.
Yeah.
That's the most American
thing. And that's what's going to happen with the American gas.
But 87, fuck you. 92, yeah, we're right.
Who's going to buy American gas?
Americans.
All Americans?
Not the Dixie Chicks.
Exactly.
See?
I think we should open American gas.
Aren't they just called the Chicks now?
Oh, yeah.
They are.
They dropped the...
Yeah.
The Dixie.
Just like Lady Antebellum. Mm. They're Lady A.
Which is fucked up.
Or awesome.
I guess, but...
People get around the American side of it by saying locally sourced. Because...
Ah.
Locally sourced.
Means that I paid somebody to go find my stuff. And they're stationed right here. But the product's coming from locally. Who knows?
I would have the biggest American flag. Like, so big, you'd see it for miles and miles.
From that Chinese drone.
Oh, you see it very easily with that. Then you see it from hundreds of miles. I'm talking a big flag.
And then you project it to a large screen.
Oh, my God.
That you could see from even further away.
Yes. Well, see, all right, you get it.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Speaking of big gas stations, have y'all been to the Buc-ee's yet?
I've not been to one,
dude. Yeah.
They're big in Texas. No. I know that.
So I went.
Oh, you did on the way back from Bali?
On the way there.
Oh, nice,
dude.
It's nuts, right?
What a shit show! What a shit show. So I have been dreaming of Buc-ee's. Like I've been reading about it. Like it's a myth. You know what I mean? Like the legend of Buc-ee's. Like all the Texans are like, oh, I get my barbecue at Buc-ee's and my lawn chairs and my propane and everything.
Yeah.
I drove past when I was coming back from Florida in April. I passed Buc-ee's 2 days before it opens. Oh, and I'm just looking at it, salivating like, oh,
forlorn.
My gosh, there's 200 gas stations. All right.
How big is it? I've never seen a picture or read anything about it. So like the big like travel plazas, how's it compared to those that have pretty much everything you need in it?
Okay, that's a good. So like you're in Maryland, you're in Delaware.
Yeah, yeah. You're going up and down the 95 corridor, and you pass the Flying J or the Travel Plaza, whatever. And it's like tons of gas stations, got multiple restaurants in it.
When you walk inside a Travel Plaza, let's use that footprint.
Okay,
Buc-ee's is larger than that.
Okay,
for sure. Outside, the footprint is at least double. And when I say double, I mean the whole footprint, the parking, the gas area, all that. Double. It's
Lee showing me a bird's eye view, which is kind of a weird
if
scale,
I said,
but
if
yes,
I
it's
said,
large for sure.
If I said they had 100
all
gas
the pumps
tanks,
right there?
Yeah.
If I said they had 100 gas pumps, I'd be underestimating.
Just thinking when you go to a Wawa and there's 18. Maybe.
Yeah. So you're going to have 10 times that.
Yeah.
bay upon bay. They must have had 30, 40 Tesla chargers.
Wow.
In that place. So when we pulled up, we're coming down the highway, and I'd been making my wife hold it. I'm like, we are going to Buc-ee's. This is the destination.
Your penis?
Florence, South Carolina. Ironically, I've always called my penis Buc-ee.
No, I mean, you said you were making her hold it.
Yeah. Hold it, honey. I got to pee. I'm not going to make it. You're going to have to hold this.
Pinch me off.
We literally stopped a place that was 60 miles from Buc-ee's to spend the night before so we could get up and time it.
And still hit Buc-ee's.
So we drive to Buc-ee's, and when we start coming up to the exit, we're looking. And we're like, is that a line for gas?
Oh,
hundreds of gas pumps, and there's cars backed up.
What's the price
down
point?
The roads, down. Man, the price point's amazing. So we go pulling around. I'm like, we're going to Buc-ee's. We pull around, and it's like if you get frustrated outside of a super packed Walmart,
that had nothing on the one Buc-ee's on the East Coast. Every asshole, every single.
You thought you were the only dickhead to think of, have this plan?
Yeah, the week of July 4th.
Week of July 4th. Every arbor.
Nobody's traveling this week, so we should be pretty good
off. It's a soft opening.
Yeah.
Every artery coming into Buc-ee's had traffic. We happened to circumvent it somehow. Like, we came off a little side ramp, scooted in. I was like, nailed it. We're looking at all the traffic. We pull in. There's nary a parking spot to be found. Every
you
pump
didn't need
is
gas.
Full. No, didn't need gas. Needed lunch and a bathroom bag. And my wife is like floating. We come around. We finally find a spot. I'm like, all right, let's go. We walk in. There's people outside taking selfies by the beaver.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's standing outside. So, like, everybody's popping selfies. There's little things. It's like, put us on Insta with the hashtag.
I was going to say, put it on the gram, right?
Yep.
Damn.
We walk in, and as soon as I open, the first thing I noticed, they had ice outside, and they had like 20-pound bags of ice for like, no, it was 10-pound bags of ice for 49 cents.
Holy cow. And, that's free.
And 20-pound bags of ice for 99 cents. And I was like, okay, I love this place.
I just bought a bag of ice this morning at Sheetz. It was like 7 pounds for like $2.50.
Yeah. No, yeah. It's 49 cents for that. And that's a 7 pound. This is a 10-pounder for 49 cents. I open up the
door. I'm going to start driving down there and get my ice.
I would too. You better get yourself a Yeti. This is a long ride. So I open the door. I open the door to Buc-ee's, and we walk in, and the throngs of humanity in there. I was like, oh my God. There was a line that backed all the way up to that door of just schmucks holding like Buc-ee's sweatshirts, Buc-ee's sandwiches.
Any onesies?
I didn't see any Buc-ee's onesies.
They're selling more merch than they are like
it's
product.
It's a full-on mall.
Dude, they had...
There's a food court in there.
They so had, how long was the line for the bathroom?
Dude, they had grills outside. They had fire pits outside. And all of them deeply discounted. Where I'm like, dude, this is better than Walmart. When we walked in, I opened that door. That line was there. And I saw that the line went all the way down the store. And then looped to a register. And then I looked to my right. And I'm like, okay, there's the bathrooms. The line for the bathrooms came out. Snaked through the other line, went back down around the other side of the store. Barbecue line, all the way back. It was just...
Did you get back in the car and leave?
Dude, I literally walked in, started walking along, and I was like, oh, that barbecue smells good. You could smell the brisket in the air. They had a taco restaurant in there. They're whipping up tacos, line all the way to the other side of the store. Every single place was just some schmuck with his arms full of shit.
You're one of them.
No, not really.
Because yes.
I walked in, my wife floating, you know, got to pee so bad. The kids got to go. And we start walking in, and I see my youngest daughter like shrink up, like, this is uncomfortable. My oldest daughter's now like, oh my gosh. And at the same time, I'm starting to be like, I can't be in here.
Yeah.
We literally walked past the peanut station, the taco station, the barbecue station. I don't know how many times I had to say, excuse me, to weasel my way through the lines and the throngs of assholes, walked through the store, hooked a left. Out that door, back on out, fuck Buc-ee's.
Now, nice. I'm glad you did that because when I see people getting in line for that sort of silliness, it just irritates me. It's like nothing's worth that. Like you could have given me stuff there and I'd have been like, no, thank you. I will move along.
Yeah, it was awful. And I was so amped up. Like I wanted to go to Buc-ee's
so were other
badly.
Thousands of people.
But they were all there, and they were waiting, and the line snaked through each other all over the place, and people with tacos and brisket, and the brisket, they had...
Probably over occupancy.
They had barbecue set. 100%, Troy. I wish you would have busted them, kicked everyone out, and been like, we're going in.
All right, Brendan, you can come in now.
Yeah, but they had everything. Lawn furniture, shirts. But the food smelled amazing.
Have you been, Lee?
I've not, but one of my coworkers did the same thing, stopped at the same one coming back from Bluffton the same week that you were down that way, and he came back with baskets of snacks from Buc-ee's. So that's all like the prepared stuff or whatever, but they had some I think they picked up some like fried chicken.
So they do like Sheetz and Wawa where like they'll have their logo on like peanuts and stuff like that.
They got Buck nuts and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I was talking to somebody about this yesterday. Like, who goes to gas stations now that aren't Sheetz and Wawa's?
Like, well, I go to that USA gas station. All the gas is sourced here in the U.S.
It's really good gas.
You pay a premium for it, but you know, it's totally worth it.
Well, I'm looking for, because they're putting, they're getting ready to put a Wawa in the new ABC store right by my house.
Yeah.
And that'll alleviate.
Right at 288?
No. I'm psyched about that.
Oh, by your house.
Robius and Winterfield.
Yeah, yeah, right before you get 288.
Right at 288, but that's cool. That's what it is. But yeah, Buc-ee's was a mess.
That place is going to print money.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing off the interstate for 5 miles in either direction.
And it's all high end.
Yeah.
So it was a very disappointing Buc-ee's experience, unfortunately.
That's a shame.
They're going to open more, though, right? Like, that can't be the first. I mean, that's the first one on the East Coast. So it's going to be like Wawa and Sheetz. It'll start spreading around.
Yeah, I haven't seen any other news for it, but like Kentucky has one now. Alabama has one now, and South Carolina has one now. I don't know if they got them in Georgia or not yet.
They announced it was coming like 2 years ago, and I remember getting amped up because I'd only heard rumors.
Are they everywhere in Texas?
Everywhere.
But you also got to think in Texas, too. You've got hundreds of miles in between some exits, and like that's why they do have 200.
Where we have a gas station almost at every exit.
Literally everywhere.
Yeah.
So is it based on location of that? Buc-ee's in South Carolina. You think it's halfway between like DC and Florida, or like between why they chose it?
Bumfuck and dipshit.
Where is it in South Carolina?
Calhoun, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's on 95,
right?
It's
near Florence.
Yeah.
But it's off at 95?
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's, you know.
You pull one every 100 miles on 95, you're just going to print money.
Yeah. It's about 60 miles south of Fayetteville.
Yeah.
I know that because I stayed in Fayetteville. Shout out to Luigi's Italian restaurant. Maybe the greatest Italian restaurant I've ever accidentally walked into from a shitty hotel. Oh, well, my.
No, I was just thinking about the location because that's why, like, just south of Petersburg at the, well, not south, but the Virginia line, Virginia-North Carolina line, there's so many hotels in Emporia because it's exactly halfway between New York and Atlanta. Most people drive 8 hours. Mm. So you go New York to Emporia, spend the night, and then Emporia to Atlanta.
And Emporia prints money with speeding tickets. Anybody who's going through, don't speed in Emporia.
Which I don't know I don't know how those hotels get by anymore, because they survived on the fact that you were able to just pull off and walk in, and now everybody does everything online.
Yeah.
And who's just stopping without planning?
Yeah.
Yeah, but Nature Boy Ric Flair's got a restaurant there, restaurant and bar.
Yeah. In Emporia?
Yeah. Yeah.
Did not know that.
What's it called? Oh, man.
The Sadler Brothers own everything. Is it called there.
Woo?
Dude, it's not far off from Woo.
Yeah.
You get 20% off if you do it for your check.
Yeah, the Sadlers own everything down there.
Which is based off their oil company.
It's called Woo Wings.
Nailed it.
Yeah. Woo Wings. See, I knew it was some dumb shit like that.
Sadler Brothers Oil. That's American oil.
There you go.
It calls it a digital restaurant business, so I'm guessing it's like a ghost kitchen. Where they just cook. They don't have, like, seating. It's
it was called Faux Show. Is what it was originally. Originally, it was Faux Show, so now maybe it's a...
Never heard the term digital kitchen.
Yeah,
kitchen or ghost kitchen.
I've heard ghost kitchen.
The hell are these things, man?
If you go on, like, Uber Eats or DoorDash or something, you'll find, like, a pizza place. You're like, man, I'm not familiar with that pizza place. And it'll be Chuck E. Cheese, but they have a different name on that. So that you'll order it, and then some DoorDash person will show up to Chuck E. Cheese, get it, and bring you that pizza, and you think you're getting it.
It's just the kitchen. There's nothing else there.
That's dirty.
Well, real dirty.
So with ghost kitchens also, in 2020 when a lot of restaurants were closed down, they would just use the space to prepare food where you aren't having any in-house eating. So that's kind of the...
Well, a lot of places have definitely gone that route. They're still staying that route. Yeah, like more takeout, more takeout. Like, I think all the Chick-fil-A's around here are basically like, please don't come in.
All right, here's what it's called. Pasquale's Pizza. If you ever pull up a DoorDash or Uber and you find Pasquale's, it's actually Chuck E. Cheese.
You talked about that.
Because the whole thing is like, if you're scrolling through DoorDash, you're going to order pizza from Chuck E. Cheese. You'd be like,
hell no.
Because their pizza is horrible.
Bring me a skee ball machine.
But Pasquale's, I'm all in on.
Sounds great. Is Chucky's Italian uncle.
Yeah.
Italian uncle.
I'm making a pizza.
Yeah, rat.
Yeah. So.
You're not fooling me, rat. I'm going to Buc-ee's.
Oh, my God.
I want my pizza from that beaver instead.
Here's the good news, though. So I left Chuck E. Cheese. I mean, I left
Set up Chuck E. Cheese.
I left Buc-ee's Cheese and drove exactly to the next exit 1 mile away. And there's this huge truck stop that I assume would normally be packed out.
Yeah.
Dude, they had like the golden skillet. They had all the good stuff. You know, this place had showers. They had a barber shop in it. Like, this is the place. We walked in. It was desolate.
Oh, I'm sure.
We pulled up. We walked in, did some shopping.
Owned the place.
I introduced the girls to CB radios. I was like, this is CB or ham radio to the cool kids. I like showed them all that. I went back. I was like, look, they have a barber shop. They have showers. This is a real
truck. There's a place if you go up 64 and head south on 81, there's a big-ass truck stop there on the left if you're heading south going to, towards right Tech. Yeah, and it's got, like, multiple restaurants
in it. What is it? Ironto?
No, Ironto has a mobile. That's a whole different.
Yeah, but I'm trying to think of the exit. It's where, like, if you took 460 to go to Roanoke, when you get to 81, it's right there.
I think that's, yeah.
No, there's some good truck stops. Truck stops are great, but this truck stop was empty because it was 1 mile from Buc-ee's.
Every time you go to a truck stop, you want to buy a CB radio, don't you?
Every time. And get some chrome.
And you look at it.
There you go.
I stop and look every time and go, I would have that one.
I do, and I'm always like, psh, I'm such a Cobra guy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Have you ever had a CB radio?
I used to have.
I did in high school.
I had the big Mac Daddy walkie talkies.
Oh, the handhelds.
In fact, my first podcast.
What was your handle?
The Virgin Buster. And I got that from.
Was
like,
it?
No, only because. Only because.
That's something a kid would need. Yeah. That's definitely.
Yeah, no, there was an older guy who was a firefighter, and he would all and like he worked at the place I worked when I was like a little kid. And he'd always be like, "Is the Virgin Buster here coming in?" And I was like,
"You stole his handle?"
Yeah, I stole his handle.
That's dirty, dude. Damn.
I was like 15, 14 years
old. Not cool. Yeah.
I didn't know the etiquette.
Clearly.
But so I used to, my dad used to like lock me in his study for like 2 hours a night. Because
it explains
a
lot.
Yeah, when my grades were bad, he would be like,
I'm sure that helped.
Mandatory study hall. So I would sit in there and have to do my homework. Well, I'd like finish my homework. And I had like taken one.
I.e., not do it.
So I would do this like pirate radio station out of there. And I would sit there and I would like hold down the button and I would like play like Led Zeppelin into it. And no joke, every once in a while, like I'd finish up a song and some trucker would be like, "You're playing the good stuff, man. That's what I'm talking about." And I'd be like, "Hell yeah. Like I got some people." And they'd be like talking to me. I was like, "That's awesome."
What was that movie with Christian Slater where he was the radio guy?
Oh, yeah, he did. He was a DJ.
Well, yeah, he was late 80s.
Was it pirate radio or something?
No.
Something. I don't know, not FM. But yeah, that
I know what
reminds
me
of that movie. That was a similar thing.
Yeah, I'd sit in my car on the CB radio and just talk to random people that I could
Everybody had them in high school.
Did you, when you were explaining the CB radios to your daughters, did you come up with names for them? Do they have like little handles?
Little handles.
Lil, L-I-L. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Just Virgin, and then this one over here is Buster.
Nice. Named them after myself. Keep it in the family.
Yeah, that was...
Stu, what was your handle?
Oh, I didn't have one.
You said everybody had one in high school.
Yeah, but...
They didn't have those.
I didn't have it.
West Virginia,
it was,
Louisiana, wherever.
No, I mean, for the most part, every single person that drove a pickup truck.
I didn't even have a pickup truck. I had a LeBaron.
Ham rodeos.
You know, when I bought that that CJ7 that was just ill-fated from the jump, it had a CB in it.
Nice.
Yeah, it had
probably didn't work like the rest
of
it.
No, it didn't.
Yeah.
It didn't.
I thought you knew you fucked up.
Yeah.
My 84 Toyota Tercel didn't come with a ham radio, with a CB radio.
my handle was Yogi Bear.
The Williamsburg Bear went by Yogi Bear. Look at that.
I used to go camping at Jellystones all the time, and I like Yogi.
I can respect that.
Yeah,
that's cool. It's not a bad I need a new handle.
You do.
I need
Virgin Buster is not...
It's not going to fly right now.
Yeah, not in 2022, brother.
Also, the fact you ripped it from another dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's probably still out there driving.
Getting confused with you.
Hey, it's Virgin Buster Jr.
Are you that snot-nosed kid back in the 80s? Are you all grown up now?
90s. I mean, 2010. I get confused.
Good save.
Decades.
All the years run together.
Yeah, I do.
This last one.
When you've been alive since 2000.
Yeah.
It's all crazy.
You just had the soul of a 90s 80s kid, right?
Yeah, that's exactly soul. Right. Ever since I got this Atari tattoo.
That's right. So probably wait a couple months if anybody's going to Buc-ee's.
Like, I honestly would. It was a total.
It'll tone down, obviously.
I would hope so. I was actually telling
my wife, at 3 a.m. I would.
No, that was exactly. I said we should go home. We should leave at like 10, so that we can pass there at like 3.
Do you think half the crowd was local?
No, dude.
Right there on 95, you got to imagine. It's all people just traveling for the holiday.
I mean, if you said it was in the middle of nowhere in South Carolina. But
it was every accent. Like it was a true melting pot of white folk.
How many Tesla chargers do they have? Did you see?
Seriously, at least 30.
Oh, really?
And almost every one of them was full. Mm. It was like when we drove past that area, it was like going to a Tesla show.
You're probably not going to drive past a Tesla charger off the interstate that isn't being occupied at the time.
These days, yeah.
Well, doesn't Tesla tell you where their chargers are in the car?
Yep. Yeah, when you go in the GPS, you can say, I either want the fastest route or I want the fastest route with chargers. And it'll calculate.
Or I think if you put the route in and you're going to go, if you're going 500 miles, it's like, you best go this way, motherfucker.
Yeah, it's
like,
basically saying at 250, you should pull over here.
Yeah.
Because you'll get a quick charge at this spot. And then that's how it routes you. It factors that into your time.
I did see a clip on the new Cadillac Lyric. That looked pretty
sweet. That thing looked sweet.
That thing was, I was like,
is it all electric?
Yeah. It's an all electric.
Cadillac has to. In fact, when we did the electric episode where we talked about electric cars, remember for 1 week when we were gonna pick a topic and like really research it, and like I did it, and then we were all like, that's fucking a lot of work.
That's a lot of work.
Yeah. So that thing's
sweet. the new Dodge.
Yeah, so Dodge is coming up with the new electric, and they're kind of like fully leaning into, this is what their quote is, a fully electrified hell sled from the automotive industry, gas chuggingest, tire smokingest, hair on your chestiest brand, Dodge.
Gotta love Dodge.
You do.
Hell sled. That is badass.
So
did you see how Dodge put the, is this what you were going to
talk? Yeah, Ely's.
Yeah.
Dude, that post was fantastic.
Yeah.
His wife's post.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know why I liked that post? She wrote it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can respect that. I can get behind that. She found an article.
Let's put it.
Did a write-up.
Let's tell everybody what it is.
So basically, the Raptor, right? The Ford Raptor, which is the baddest, has been for a while now, right? It's the baddest pickup truck you can get.
White Knight has one.
Yeah, he does have one. It's beautiful. But you know what? He had the one with the V8 before it.
Yeah.
And now he has the one with the
V6.
The V6 with the twin turbos on it. And that thing's probably arguably just as fast, but I can't get over the fact that I don't hear that roar.
That rumble.
That badass. When he used to fire up the old Raptor, blah, 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 blah. And I was like, that is sick.
It's V8.
Now when he fires it up, it's like, we're going to go. but it does. It goes. Like, I can't complain.
It does go.
But so Dodge decided, screw that. They've been dropping Hellcat motors in every single thing they make, which is the baddest V8 you can get your hands on. And so they dropped it in their pickup truck version. And they literally have on the cowl, on the actual, like, on the
TRX engine, T-Rex.
On the engine, it has a T-Rex.
With a Raptor.
With a Raptor in its fucking mouth. And I'm like, that is awesome.
Raptors, I mean, they sound cool, but that is weak in the dinosaur world, right?
It never was a badass. I mean, aren't the Raptors the one in Jurassic Park that are running around?
Yeah, they're like 6 foot tall.
Talk to each other.
I mean, I'm scared a little, but not as scared as I am of T-Rex.
Well, the best thing is that Ford has been forever trying to go back to the V6 in this article, and Dodge is just like, screw it, we're going to keep putting big old V8s in every single car, whether it's a sedan, trucks, or whatnot. And they basically goaded Ford into now putting... Because what was the end of this story? That Ford's now going to put...
Oh, they're putting a nasty V8 in there.
In what truck? Or was it a car? They're putting a Raptor engine, a Ford V8 and something.
Probably in the Raptor to make it more badass.
I would hope so. The guys who buy Raptors aren't worried about fuel economy.
No.
They're worried about badassness, which is a word.
I think there's a lot of cars that people buy these days that they throw a lot of thought into the wind and just say, fuck it, I don't care. Yeah. This just looks cool.
Most people love, we're a car culture, and people do not, people that make minimum wage don't think twice about buying a $45,000 Mercedes. You know, like, they just don't. It's just, I want a cool car, I'm going to pay for a cool car.
My wife and I looked at the Durango, and we test drove the V6, and we test drove the Hemi. And I was like, honey, we don't need the V6, or we don't need the Hemi. Like, clearly this is better gas mileage with this and everything. And she's like, yeah, but listen to that. And I was like, no, I'm not arguing with you.
Yeah.
I'm just putting out pros and cons. Pros, sounds better, faster. Cons, horrible gas mileage, but badass. We bought the Hemi.
Yeah.
So there's Ford's response is next week they're going to be revealing the Raptor R, which is a supercharged V8.
That's what I'm talking about. Now it's forced induction with a V8. Come on now. I'm getting wet.
Yeah, you are.
No, like seriously, I'm moist.
Yeah. I do not doubt you.
That's what the R.
Oh, R. Wait, what?
What's for remoist. Wetter.
Yeah, Dodge is always about that. Like, they're basically calling Ford a bunch of chumps.
Which I respect.
Call their bluff, and then, I mean, to Ford's credit, they're coming back at them. And Ely will tell you, if you're going to buy a truck, you're buying a Ford or a Dodge. Like, that's what you want.
Yeah. I mean, you can get the Toyota, get a little reliability, but there's something about
it. They look like hell now.
Yeah, I'll always be like a Tacoma fan, like a smaller pickup truck. I think
Buddy of mine just picked up a brand new Tacoma. Like the smaller one? That's the smaller one. Because the Tundra's the big one. Yeah,
exactly.
Right. He just picked up the smaller one and it's brand new. It's pretty sweet on the inside, but it just, I don't know. The newer styles are quite getting there.
I just picked up the new 1985 4Runner with the full old man Emu lift, 33s on it. You guys see it in the driveway when you came in?
Yep. Yeah.
Nope, you didn't.
Missed it.
You didn't. Because literally, as soon as I picked it up from the shop, like driving it, I'm like, man, it is really hard to turn.
Oh, no.
I'm like, huh. And like, I took it back in. Like, my wife's like, I can't drive this. I'm like, yeah, it's really hard to turn the wheel. So I took it back in there, and the guy's like, no, man, it's got the lift. Like, it's just going to be harder to turn. Like, the steering's all different. Like, it's just kind of got to nut up.
Different squat, different stance.
He's like, he tell you to nut up while you were wearing a Dixie jacket?
That's awesome.
The look at he
that's
never
an attack.
He never said the words nut up, but the look on his face was clearly, hey, nut up, collared shirt boy. You know what I mean? And I'm like, bro.
I'll be back in 30 minutes, sir.
Yes.
And I was like, buddy, like, I went under the hood. Like, I had my wife turn it. Like, the power steering pump is not engaging. And he's like, nah, that's just how it turns. I test drove it. It's fine. And I was like, well, why don't you take a look at it? Like, just take a look.
Why don't you nut up, sir?
Yeah, yes. Just take a look.
Friendly.
And so he gets in there, and like, he's like looking at it, and he's like, oh, man, you're right. Like, I'm not hearing the power steering pump. I was like, yeah, I think you got an air bubble in the line.
Did you really tell him that the power steering pump wasn't engaging and that there's an air bubble in it? You assessed the situation for the mechanic?
Well, Ely came over.
Yeah.
No.
I made a phone call.
YouTube would be the problem.
Can I phone a friend?
I go, I think there's air in the lines because it's not turning. It doesn't feel right. He's like looking at me like I'm fucking crazy, right? And then he's like, he's testing. He's like, nah, man, that's how every one of my trucks feels. And then he goes in there and he looks in and he pours some power steering fluid in. And this thing's like, like slurping it down. And I'm like,
Yeah, because you're supposed to fill that to the top. Like that's
dude,
yeah.
He installed all the shit just right. And I'm not talking smack. Like this dude actually went home and pulled a couple brackets off of one of his trucks to put it on because he was like, they didn't order your brackets. And he knew I'd been waiting months for all the parts. Like, he did a good job, except for the fact that he didn't put any fluid in the damn power steering reservoir. So the whole thing's just like,
dried up,
dying
Sahara.
A slow death. And so, like, he filled it up and got it to work. And he was like, well, that's my bad, dude. He's like, I got egg on my face. Like, I feel horrible. Like, I bled it, and I forgot to, like,
fill it.
He's like, I replaced all the stuff.
Yeah, but
he's
that's like, a mistake you can get. Like, you can look past that. Like, that's like, I get it. Like,
no, so I was like, my bad. And then the
damage was done.
And then the truck wouldn't start.
Oh, there you go.
I'm like, what the hell? And on the way over there to take it back to him, like, the charged battery light's on. I'm like, oh.
Well, you can have one thing. You can have steering or running. Which do you want?
Yeah.
You greedy bastard.
So now it's literally back in there, now getting an alternator put in. Like, I cannot win with this truck right now.
But if you ask him next week, he'll be like, I only paid $2,500 for that truck.
Greatest truck he's ever had.
I did only pay $2,200.
Oh, my bad.
Okay.
Ooh.
Yes.
The other $300 went away very quickly, though.
But if we start to add up all the things I've done since, but
I wish you.
It's a 20 grand truck.
it's climbing. I certainly put far more work into it in the last month than I purchased the car for.
Yes.
There's no doubt about that. And now an alternator, which he felt so bad about. The guy was like, how many hours did that take to do? A couple hours? And he looked at me and he goes, one.
Yeah.
And he was like, I'm going to take this one on the arm, buddy. Yeah.
Well, make sure it gets done before September because I need to take it back to the race for the Toyota parking.
I can oblige.
Okay.
I can oblige. Well, I think I can oblige.
Before you get back in it, just pop the hood and make sure the alternator's in it.
Yeah.
And there's a pulley on it.
Yeah.
It's been a hodgepodge of issues, man.
Make sure that blinker fluid's filled up, too, for it.
I can't even find the reservoir.
Is he at least going to throw in some muffler bearings for you?
They sold me muffler bearings and the red, but I can't find where to put the blinker fluid or the muffler bearings. I've looked everywhere.
Yeah, just YouTube it.
Yeah, your tube.
I only TikTok now.
TikTok.
Yeah, 15 seconds to show me where that blinker fluid goes, and I'm out.
Yeah, if you don't have blinker fluid, you get hit in the rear end while the blinker's on. The whole thing blows up.
Are you serious?
Oh, that's how my great-grandfather went. Too soon.
Lost a lot of good men that way.
Yeah.
Old Blinker Bauer.
That's right.
It's so ironic because they named him that years prior. Should we do it like I even need a deli? I'm lubed up. But tis the time.
Pretty lubed up.
Tis the time. Oh, you're just going to take it upon yourselves, too?
Well, he's glad he could help out.
Respect. The one that's not Miller Lite.
It's hard to find.
I don't know. We could do that in Miller Lite. We haven't done that in a while.
We only need three.
Yep.
Troy's doing the old spit take.
Give it a taste. Oh, Stu, you got a different one. No. Don't pour it over the board. Yeah, there we go. That's good. What do we have here?
Okay, so this is interesting. This is the gumball head from Three Floyds.
What color does this look like to you, Brendan?
The can?
Yes.
Lots of blues.
Lots of blues.
All blues.
And a red.
Well, and there's a red.
Yellow, green, red, blue, purple.
It's very like
American wheat pale ale.
See why this was perfect for
Gumball
Ely?
Head,
I got a nice
Floyd.
Wheat beer for him that was also a pale ale. I literally did everything right.
Yeah.
It's not normal.
That's what it says
on the side
Three
of the
Floyd.
That has every color in the rainbow on it. And then maybe some made up ones.
There are a lot of made up colors on this.
Gumball Head.
Smells delicious.
I'm anticipating this being the perfect beer.
You've never been wrong.
Literally all the time. All the time.
Speaking of cars, I did the whole, like, charge up your AC the other day. I'd never done that. My car's 17 years old.
Did you get the little, like, gun with the hose on it?
Yeah, the whole, like,
kick the
boodle,
cartridge in.
And I was like, this is probably easy, right? And then I'm thinking, well, nothing ever goes. No simple job ever goes.
It's got the little gauge on it.
Yeah, it had the gauge on and everything. And sure as shit, if that wasn't a five-minute job and it worked like a charm, I was, like, standing there, like, what? Like
you literally start the car, right?
Yep.
Turn on the AC.
Yep.
Pull the trigger.
Yeah.
And then you watch the thing go up until it hits the point where it's full. And you go, okay, then.
Then you stand there and look at it and go, how was it that easy? And then I'm thinking, I would have dropped that
$300.
Yeah, I would have dropped that car off. It would have been there for half a day. Yeah. They would have done the same thing and charged me $300 for it.
What did that kit cost you?
So they come in a lot of different sizes and price points, and I just went mid-grade.
Sure.
And it was like 50-some bucks. I think after tax, it was like right at 60 bucks, and I was like...
Yeah, so that's literally $240 for that dude to screw the thing on, pull the trigger, and wait until it gets to the right level, unscrew it, and go, hey, that'd be $240.
Yeah, we got to move your car out of the way now. Since you haven't even left the lot yet.
They'll call it a two-hour job.
Easily.
Oh, I did have something else weird happen. So I had my wife's car at the shop getting an oil change. So I was coming back in my work vehicle, and I was passing by it, and I didn't see the car in the parking lot. So I was like, maybe. So I whipped in there. I was like, maybe it's on the lift. So I did a loop through there, and it wasn't on the lift. And I'm like, all I'm getting is an oil change. No inspection, like this should be, just put it on lift change oil. So I park and I'm walking around. And I'm like, I literally walk around the lot three times, looked in the bay four times. Just like, did I miss it? Like, what? The car's not there. I'm like, did the car get stolen? Like, I'm very confused. Why would my car not be here? And I've used this place 100 times. I take all my cars there. They're great. So I walk in and I'm like, I dropped my wife's car off here and I haven't heard from y'all today. And they were like, the CRV? And I was like, yeah. And they were like, oh, the TPS light came on and we're just taking around the block to see if we did it or if it was like that. And I was like, oh, that's why you would. I was like, yeah. I didn't see it. I didn't know if, like, because I dropped it off the night before. I was like, didn't know if it got stolen or something. He was like, no, it'll be back in a second. Because I was like, why is, did they that's outsource crazy. this oil change or something?
Yeah, we're
like,
going to send it down to Jiffy Lube real quick.
Exactly. Yeah.
Exactly. That'll be $110.
I seriously kind of thought that. I was like, it wouldn't be off the lot for any other reason. And then I guess they were doing the right thing.
One of my old coworkers, they had their family car stolen from a dealership. They dropped it off, same kind of thing, at night for service or whatever. They were going to on vacation, and they're like, this is perfect. We can drop it off, leave it there for the whole week, don't have to deal with it. They get a call like 2 days later from like the state police, and it was like, sir, we need you to come claim your car or whatever. And he's like, what are you talking about? Some kids stole it, took it on a joyride, crashed it into a bridge abutment, left it and everything else. So insurance is calling him, like,
thinking they did it.
Thinking
so then they got to prove that they
exactly.
didn't do it.
Yeah, that they had to prove that they were out of town on vacation and everything.
I know Brendan knows this, but did you guys ever hear how a Monte Carlo got stolen and used in a jewelry heist?
Yours? I don't think you ever told that story.
No.
Oh, God. So, well, it's long. It's not that long, but we can do the deli if you want to.
Yep.
Finish up the deli.
Like to lock that deli up, get it over with.
Just in case.
You seem to be talkative. Why don't you start, Stu?
I'm actually liking this pale ale.
Okay, good. Tell us more.
The artwork is way over the top. Too many colors, very busy. I wouldn't even, like, reading Gumball Head is kind of rough. But it says it's got has a lemony finish to it, which I'm having a hard time picking
up. I don't taste that at all. That's the beauty of bad eyes. I can't actually read anything on there. Yeah. So never saw that.
But I like the, it's a weird
beer.
You're
not tainted by the, you don't fall into the marketing schemes of all these beers.
Nope.
Yeah. Brendan notoriously
you're
avoids
about that truth.
No,
marketing.
I think I'm liking this beer because of the way it finishes. It's not harsh. It just dissipates all the flavors up front.
Actually, now you said lemon.
Oh, it's.
I taste the lemon on the back end.
Oh, okay.
Let's do plant a seed.
I'm not kidding.
No shit. And look how quickly it grew.
But yeah, so I'll give this a 3.
Okay.
I'm not big on the artwork, but I'm really digging the flavor. So,
are you docking points because of the artwork?
Yeah.
Wow, ballsy.
Marketing.
I thought the marketing looked cool.
It's.
You know, it looked like an 80s, like, 80s punk band kind of vibe, but colorful.
Yeah, they're going for, like, the whole gumball machine. That's what it, I mean, this is, like, it makes me think of, like, I don't know.
Gum?
Pink pop soda. I don't know.
Pink pop soda. Or pink soda pop.
Coke.
Nope.
What? Are you having a stroke?
All right, so you went with the 3.
I'm just going.
What's the ABV on this?
5.2.
Is that what it's on?
Somebody go.
5.6.
Nobody knows.
Oh, 6.
No way to know.
Yeah.
I'll go. Here's what I find interesting about this. There is a. It's not an aftertaste. It's a mid taste.
Mm-hmm.
And that mid-taste does remind me of bubblegum, but a very specific bubblegum. It is the powder that you find on, like, if you open an old pack of, like, Topps baseball cards and there's, like, a shitty piece of brittle gum in there. And there's that powder there. That same powder was also used on Bazooka Joe, gum.
Yeah, the square gum with the cartoon.
Yeah, and that little bit of powder there to keep the comic from sticking.
Right.
And the paper from sticking and from keeping it to stick to the baseball cards. That powder is probably why they named it Gumball Head, because there is a very distinct mid-level flavor to me that reminds me of that powder. And I don't know how else to describe that.
Do you think they're adding it?
No, I think they fucked up. And they go, damn it. Tastes like old Topps bubblegum in the middle, and they go,
we need a name.
We'll call it Gumball Head. Now, if I remove that from the equation, I taste a little bit of that lemon on the end, which I think is them trying to bump up the wheat.
Mm.
The hop profile is pretty mellow. It's very easy drinking. But I don't think it does any of those things particularly well. But I don't think it does anything disagreeable. I'm actually going to stick with Stu here. Like, I would drink this again. So it's not going to be a 2.5. For me, that's a 3. But there's that weird powdery gumball taste right in that mid flavor that I find very interesting and unique. Not good, not bad, just unique. Mm. 3.
Troy, you seem to agree with what Brendan was saying.
Yeah, I thought you hit the nail on the head because I thought the taste on the front end was good and the back end wasn't bad. Finished a little lemony, a little sour. I wasn't thinking lemon, but I was thinking sour until Stu picked it out. Maybe that's what I'm tasting. But to me, the mid was a little metallic as well. I picked up what you were talking about, but I really grasped on the point when you said the mid. And the mid was
the mid weird flavor.
The mid flavor was a little off to me. So I don't know. I don't think I really like this beer. But again, this isn't a bad beer. So I'm going to go right down the middle, 2.5. It's just nothing is jumping out that I'm like, oh, I really like this about it. And that's why I would like to have it again. If I'm going to pay, you know, for a microbrew, like I'm gonna want to grab something I know I'm gonna like mm-hmm. that just doesn't check those boxes for me. So 2.5.
I actually find this beer very good. I get a little bit of the bitterness from the hops, the wheat and the orange, the citrus, that flavor I like a lot, and it's a nice blend for me. It's not too over the top.
It says it's brewed with Amarillo hops.
Yeah, so I think that all in all, it's a pretty good pale ale. It's a pretty good wheat together. I think it's above average. I don't really get any.
I guess the wheat's cutting the pale ale down.
Yeah, and I think that's where you're getting a little bit of the bitterness up front. I think like you're getting that pale ale, and then it kind of transitions into that citrusy, weedy hefeweizen.
It's definitely dry hopped. Like it's not a hoppy beer. It's just got the aromas.
Yeah. I'm gonna give this a 3.5. I think it was very good. Don't get that bubblegum flavor. I had to look up to see what it was, and apparently a lot of different bubblegum manufacturers used like a sweetened talc.
Yeah.
Is effectively what it was. Basically. To help absorb oils to keep
them sticking. Abacus wasn't around for those years.
No.
Weren't either, Brendan. You just read about them, right?
No. Yeah. No, it's because I was a big collector.
That's right.
Yeah. A vintage thing.
It's the same thing you were able to blow off the gum cigarettes that they used to sell.
Yep.
It was the powder that you could get.
I'll be damned. That's accurate. Not that I've ever.
Yeah. All in all, I'll say 3.5, and in part just to get this to level right out at a 3, where I think it needs to be.
Boom. Yeah. I think that's where it is.
Sounds about right. Well, can't argue that.
Good job. You didn't win, nerd.
Man, whoever brought this.
Yeah.
Well, if Ely had been here, he would have given it a 5.
Would I don't know.
Thrown the whole thing off.
I don't know about that.
No, it wouldn't have happened.
He always surprised me with some of the ones that he did like. He would sit there and just like lay back quietly in the cut and just be like,
"You never know."
Never say anything. And then the moment he gets to like doing his review, he's like, "I fucking love this beer.
I really love this. Yeah, this is my new favorite beer."
Yeah.
Did y'all ever fall prey to like door-to-door salespeople?
You know.
It's crazy you said that because last night I had a good one come by my house.
Okay, what do you got? Talk to me, Troy.
Dude, this kid came by.
Kid.
I mean, way younger than me. I mean, he looked like he could have been in high school, maybe early 20s. And I haven't bought anything from this kid yet, and I probably never will. But damn if he didn't make me stand there while he pitched all this shit. And he came at me with this. I'd never seen this. This kid's like, oh, hey. He's like, yeah. He's like, I'm going door to door. You know, your neighbors, the Joneses over here. You know, Matt and Sarah. You know, and their little boy, Mikey. He's sweet. And then
So he's dropping names.
That's the
move.
And he's hitting them. He's hitting them. And he's like, oh, your neighbors over there, they bought. And I was like, finally, after like 8 couples and their kids, and he's like, you know, little Mikey loves racing slot cars on the weekend. Like he's literally like going like into it. And I'm like, and he starts showing me pictures of him like literally taking selfies with the parents at the door holding a book. I'm like, what are you selling? He's like, other educational books, you know, to help your kids, you know, your neighbors, Scott and, you know, Jesse, they told me your kids are in middle school, and I'm like,
snitches.
I'm like, he still never told me what he was selling other than educational books. But like, he got into nothing, and then he's like seeing the blank wash over my face, and he's like,
just losing you.
He's like, well, I'm assuming like most households, you know, mom takes care of all the education. So, you know, when's she going to be around? And she's not here, right? I was like, no. He's like, maybe tomorrow. He's like, can I come by like 9 o'clock? I was like, no.
Trying to bone your wife?
He's like, what kind of car she drive? How do I know when she's here?
Oh.
And I was like,
this dude's legit. This guy's going to go places in the end.
He is. He really is. He put the hard sell on me. And actually, now that I'm saying it into the mic, I never told her about this, so he might have swung by.
Tonight? Right now?
You're going to come home, it's going to look like a library. Then his buddy shows up, sells the bookshelf.
My dad, my stepmom are there. Like, it's going to be weird. I still don't know what he was selling other than educational books. For school-age kids.
Had the exact opposite happen today. So I'm driving back in the neighborhood about 11 a.m., and there's a tree company.
Full day of work for Stu.
No shit.
Put in a hard one.
Yep.
Kid shows up and goes, hey, fuck you. opposite.
So there's a tree service company probably like a street up doing work, and there's this little, like, really, really tiny soft knock on the door, like just doot, doot, doot. And my dogs didn't even hear it, but I heard it because I just happened to be in the office. And I go answer the door, and there's this 12-year-old kid, literally 12. He's got a light Spanish accent, and he's like, hands me the card, and he's like, gutters?
Gutters?
And he goes, gutters,
yes,
mulch,
I have them.
And tree. If you need anything, and he points to my entire front yard. And then I'm like,
you have all of these things,
thank
sir.
Thank you very much. I know your dad's probably up here cutting trees, and he's just sending you around the neighborhood.
That's the move. That's the move.
Like, you know, but my front yard is, one, I have no grass. Two, I've got a bazillion trees, and I get hit up at least once a week.
Dude, they come through my neighborhood tree work, all the time. With, and I had got to, a week or two ago stop and knock on my door, and I answer. He's like, yeah, we're in the neighborhood. I looked across the street. Another one of his guys, like, there was a guy in a truck just coasting, and then they were hitting the houses. And he's like, yeah, you know, we're doing, he gives me his cards, like, we're doing free estimates. I was like, okay, thanks. He's like, you need an estimate? I'm like, no, I'm good. He's like, are you sure? I'm like, I don't want anything cut down, dude. Like, I don't have a lot of trees, and I want them all. Like,
I had one guy who looked like he was cracked out of his mind. He's like in his late 20s.
Oh, that's the guy.
And he was like, I'm down from Charlottesville. I'm here for like just another 4 hours. I need a little bit of work. I need, you know, it's been slow season. I'll cut everything right now for $1,500. Like, no, I don't need it right now. I'm sorry, you're down on your luck. And everybody else is giving me like $3,000 quotes. But I'm like,
yeah.
Nah,
yeah,
it's
I don't
okay.
need the crack.
Are you licensed and insured?
Yeah,
you know,
that insurance?
When the tree falls on my house, what's happening?
Yeah, I had the tree guy give me a $3,000 quote on taking a couple trees down. And I was like, when? He's like, right now. And it was him and one dude. And I go, what? And he goes, it's Sunday afternoon. You're going to need a crew. Nah, man, we got it. I said, how long is it going to take? He goes, 3 hours. I'm like, you want $3,000 for 3 hours worth of work? Am I in a surgery suite or something?
I need a new gallbladder now.
Yeah. I was like, get the hell out. And then I was like, I'm good. And he's like, well, let's negotiate. I'm like, so if I paid you $3,000, you would have been like, okay, cool. But if I talked you down to two, you'd take that too? So you were willing just to take my extra gur? Like,
yeah, it's where he starts.
I hate that shit.
So So the other night, right, I'm watching Stranger Things with my daughter, and a mouse.
I saw you on Be Real.
That's right. So a mouse casually just walks through the room.
Love that for you.
And I'm like, oh, sweet, that's a mouse. And like, I see it go by the trash can.
Love when they do walk like slowly through a room because they're at home.
Yeah, they're like, you're taking a stroll.
Oh,
yeah.
You're still up? Oh, no big deal.
Hey,
oh, yeah.
How you
100%.
Doing?
100%. This mouse lives here.
Did he finger guns you when he walked by? Like, hey, bro.
What's up, buddy? So, like, I'm like.
Got any of that Chuck E. Cheese?
I'm like, hey, did you see that mouse? She's like, what are you talking about? I was like, oh, give it time. Sure enough, the mouse comes walking out from that trash can, casually walks by, and I was like, do you see it now? And she's like, oh, my gosh. And I'm like, yeah, that's definitely a mouse going by. Like,
why are people so scared of tiny little mice? I've never understood that. Like,
I think actually what I told her, I said, if you get in a fight, you're going to win.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I feel like they fight dirty.
I don't give a shit.
That's a rat, not a mouse.
Like, you're going to win. I get that there's that initial level of shock.
Yeah, sure.
But when it comes down to it, like, I'm going to win this fight.
Afraid of.
So say this is a week ago, right? Like, the mouse just casually walks through and makes a sandwich and then leaves the room. Mm. Then all of a sudden my other daughter comes down like a couple days later and she's like, there's a roach upstairs.
What is your house turning into?
I don't know.
Fucking animal farm.
Then my wife the other day is like,
It's called a pest service.
Yeah. So she's like, there's a bunch of ants in the kitchen. Now, what I have never explained to them is that there's like a bunch of ants behind that outlet in here, and like, I'll pull things out of it and the ants will come screaming out like, why are you pulling out the stuff on the outlet? And I'm like, bro, you're in my room. And I have been
all of these neighborhoods that we live in around here, I mean, they're old growth. The neighbors have been around 40, 50 years and they're 100-foot trees. And it's like,
yeah,
we live in the woods. Yeah. Like, we're in their area.
So I mean, out here in this
room. He
probably
gets it. He lives out in the middle of nowhere.
I've seen a couple spiders that are suspicious at best.
Yeah.
Like up in the corners out here in the pallet house. And I've been coming out here with the shop vac every couple of weeks, just sucking them up. Yeah. So now they're just, you
inside
should see
the shop
vac. Yeah, you should see what's in the shop vac. Holy shit.
You just hope they can't get they're back not, out.
Battle them in there.
Yeah. There's crossbreeding. I have brown widows and black recluses at this point. Like, these are the most potent thing. Tarantulas with scorpion tails. Like, this is like, it's sketchy in there.
But so danger, like, dome.
But so, like, I'm fully aware that, like,
a little bit of radiation, he's turning into Spider-Man.
Yeah. So in this room, I've fed roaches to turtles. This room's got some shit. Oh, but I don't address
when moths come in here, we throw them in the turtle tank.
But I don't address it because I'm like, I'm a man. I hit it with some Febreze. Now at least they smell Stunning. Good. Yeah. I'll smell them coming. I'll be like, that Mediterranean lavender? No, I think we got roaches. But so I've seen all these, like, the vermin, right, show up.
Do you not have a pest company?
Well, I haven't had a pest company since I moved here.
What do you get dogs for? So, too.
So today,
yeah,
I'm
they don't
literally
kill ants and roaches.
I'm in the middle of, like, multiple, like, Zoom calls. Like, today was one of these days, like, back to back to back. Well, one of them ended 15 minutes early, and I think, finally, a man can shit in peace. I go take a deuce. I drop a horrific deuce. And as soon as it falls from my ass, before it hits the water, the doorbell's like, bing, bong.
Oh, God.
And I'm like, curses. And I'm thinking
Don't
to myself.
Don't even get to enjoy the rest of your poo.
No, I got a bidet. This is another 5 minutes of, like, pure joy. But I know that my daughter's getting picked up by, like, somebody. They're going out. Irrelevant to the story. So I'm like, oh, shit. The parents are here. Like, I got to run down and get this. So I do, like, the solo quick wipe, which is not an effective
Risky.
Wipe. Yeah, it's just like,
it's a bold, that's a bold move, Cotton.
Yeah. It's a bold move, Cotton. I run down the stairs and I open up the door, and there's this, like, young, good-looking woman in, like, yoga pants.
Work, Go on.
Hiking boots.
I'm listening. Mm.
Yoga pants and hiking boots?
Yeah. Never thought I'd like this.
She's on her feet all day.
Long fingernails. Like too long. The kind of fingernails you don't take home to mom.
I don't like this.
But if you're in a strip club, you're like, I'll pay you $20 to scratch my back. You know, not that long. But, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah. Not coke nails, but.
Yeah.
Like, she gets her nails dead.
Is this a mom or a babysitter?
Dude, she's like 20. And no,
Stu hasn't figured out.
It's not
to pick up the daughter.
Yeah, it's not to pick up the daughter.
It's a rando chick.
And when I say her ass is somewhere between, like, Brazilian and, like, whatever the next best thing is, and I'm like, what do you want? You know, like, what are we doing here? And she's like,
guys, get me a strippogram. What's going on?
Yeah. And so she's like, but she's like doing, like, the 10 feet back thing, which I respect.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, can I help you? And she's like, yeah, I work for such and such pest company.
Ooh.
And I'm like, oh, literally the only thing I desperately need right now. And I'm like, tell me more. And she's like, all right, well, we have a truck in the neighborhood and we just had two cancellations. So we're open today. So I've got this. And, like, usually it costs this, but I could do literally half. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm raising a hand because I have a question. Who cancels their pest service?
Nobody.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just wanted to make sure that we were.
So I literally used to do this for a contracting company. And the whole shtick was, hey, we're in the area.
We'll cut you a deal.
So yeah. Since we're in the area, I'd like to give free estimates today. This was the whole spiel. Yeah.
And that's the last time you'd see her because Billy Bob's going to show up with a truck, come on in there and just take care of the ants.
Yeah, well, it was Brandon. Not Billy Bob. But he kind of looked like a Billy Bob. But so, like, I'm like, oh, damn it. Like, now I got to hear this because I actually do have a need. Like, every woman in this house is freaked out.
And you like buying things from attractive women.
I love buying things from attractive women. So then as soon as she sees me not go get the fuck out of here, the 10 feet turns to one.
Oh, no.
Like, immediately. And then she's like, well, let me show you this. And she's like showing me the card, and I'm like, you're not in the fucking neighborhood. This is a laminated fucking like this is bullshit. But she's like,
you, the hot sales chick, happen to be in the neighborhood with the tech? Yeah, I'm sure.
So here's where it gets worse, though. She's like, hey, so we got this service, and it's like $300. And I'm like, yeah, that sounds exorbitant. I don't know what this should cost, but that sounds exorbitant. And she's like, and we do all of this here. And then she's got all these add-ons, like, we get rid of mice. I'm like, I got a fucking mouse problem. And then she's like, can we get rid of this? And we get rid of this? And it just starts just laddering down to everything that's wrong with my house. And she's like, well, how many square footage? And I was like, look.
Flashback 2 weeks when she's releasing mice out front, right. Releasing cockroaches. Yeah.
After she got an email from China, exactly. You find the drone around.
It's a plan. Oh, shit.
So then all of a sudden she's like, well, you know, if we do this today, of course, I'll do this for
today,
half price.
Today only.
Yeah. She's like, so we can do it for half price. And then she's like, but I can throw in this.
But wait,
there's more. Yeah. And I'm like, well, look, I really got to talk to my wife about this. Like, this is not my thing. And she's like, well, is she gonna
I'm not man enough to handle the pest in this house. Yeah, yeah.
There's a roach.
But that's always the default, right? Like, sure, I'm not going to make a decision like this without my wife. And then she's like, well, you know, if we do it today, then we'll throw in the mouse thing for free. And we'll throw in this. And all of a sudden, all these $79 add-ons start coming in for free. And I'm like, holy shit. So I have a 2-year contract where I'm literally, because I'm like running out of time. My next call is in 5 minutes. And I'm
got to make a decision right now or
let's take a step back and remember, I have Dookie in my ass. Like, I can't be here. Yeah. Like, oh, I thought this was, but her pitch was spot on.
You're in no way to make a life-altering decision like this.
I'm telling you, I could
The stars aligned.
If I made a joke that was remotely clever.
Oh, God.
She was like...
And you don't do that very often. Yeah, exactly.
Her closing ratio with men is 100%. With women is 0. Dude,
she laughed at literally anything I said that was in the ballpark of funny. Every single time. And then she'd like send a joke back. And like, I was like, awesome.
So we've had pest service for as long as we've been in the house.
I used to have Loyal in the other neighborhood.
Yeah. So, and I've had the same pest guy the whole time.
And he was my guy. Yeah.
Yeah. So like my pest guy, like, knows my kids, is watching my kids be born and grow. Like, it's pretty cool, but it's like $70 every 3 months.
It's not that bad.
What? Yeah.
And like,
he's in for $300. And by the way,
does he do mice?
Yeah. Yeah. He does. Because most, they do all that stuff. Like, while they're
Is it
there.
Fully organic?
Yes.
Pet safe, kid free?
Totally.
Kid safe?
Totally.
Yeah. Who's out here putting not kid and pet safe stuff down?
I don't know. I felt like this
You
was
really should have waited for your wife.
And no shit!
You know what's cool, though? They will, like, or mine, like, he comes every 3 months. They call and schedule. But they will
every
come
three
back.
Months.
Yeah,
I'm every 2 months.
Oh well, I was gonna say they'll come back. They'll come back if you want more. Like if you see something, like if you start having
see
something,
say something.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, no. So that was the best part. I was like, what kind of guarantees? There, she was like, if your wife sees an ant, call
A
us up.
Single ant. Yeah. I'd be throwing ants in the house every day.
Dude, my wife is like, we go through.
She's gonna love this.
We go through a different mosquito company every year because they fire us.
Because she annoys the hell out of them.
Yeah, because she will literally, like, it'd be like a week after treatment.
She sees a single mosquito.
A single mosquito. She'll be like, oh, shit, that's a mosquito.
She's got them
she
on calls speed dial.
Yeah, no, she calls them up.
You can't live where you live and expect, even with the mosquito treatment company coming by, that you're not going to have mosquitoes.
Oh, we can.
How's that going?
We have to get a new one every
You're also the
year.
Same couple that has a screen and porch that props the door open.
Yeah, because of her dogs.
Well, her dogs.
Her,
no, I have a dog. My dog's cool. He opens doors himself. But her little deaf dog can't figure out that shit.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
He's got needs.
I can see your wife now calling the mosquito company, giving them an earful about how there's so many mosquitoes in her screen porch, and that's not acceptable for her.
Now, I get treatment in the lawn. We're getting rid of grubs. You get rid of grubs?
I care nothing about my lawn.
Yeah. Just desperately trying to figure out why I'm paying $150.
Did you plug the name?
Every 2 months. No.
Did you use the coupon code, Abacus?
Oh, dude, you know you're the coupon guy. Okay, cool. That was Troy's idea. Yeah. A good one.
Yeah, I asked Brendan like 100 times to get the coupon code fixed because I had people hit me up, and he's like, yeah, I'll get to it. He's like, I just got to think of something because I didn't want to use Bowflex again. I was like,
I didn't like Bowflex.
Well, you don't have to answer this, but I would say in my real estate career, I've been using
$150 every 2 months.
Yeah, but I'm getting full treatment.
Oh, yeah.
Again, if he sees a single pest in his yard,
yeah.
If he sees a piss pal, that thing's
dead. No, piss pals are cool. Oh, but you know, so
piss pal safe?
I've had mouse traps in my house now because that damn mouse for what? 6 hours? The dog has chewed one up and ruined the carpet. There's blue shit all over the carpet. I'm just waiting for the dog to die.
They put him out where the dog can get to him?
They were tucked away. I don't know how the dog... But look, I left the house. I made the mistake of, God forbid, leaving my house. And the kids ran amok and they let the dog in. And this thing carried it upstairs and chewed it up all over the carpet.
Nice.
That's going to end well for him.
Yeah.
With the best... So I looked up the traps. And I was like, damn, he was so close to never doing that again. Because the stuff inside smells great, sure. It attracts mice. But inside of this thing is two bear traps that'll just come down. Like, these come down with the wrath of God on these mice. And if he had just gotten half an inch further.
The feeders we have, the mice eat it and then go away and die. It doesn't kill any mice.
Well, see, the problem there is then you get a dead mouse somewhere in your house.
If it doesn't make it out, but sure. I don't think a lot of times they stick around.
Yeah,
so as she described it to me, I said, how does this work? Because we have a bunch of humane traps that I'm going right now. Mm-hmm. She goes, oh, no, what these do is they have something in them that they eat, and it makes them so dehydrated that they either have to find their way to a steady water source for the next couple of days, or they just die of dehydration. I was like, that's the opposite of humane. And she's like, I know. And I'm like, you're fantastic, Victoria.
At this point, is she just like rubbing the back of your head?
Of course her name's Victoria. It's not like Molly.
No, no, Victoria.
Not Gertrude, but Victoria.
For real estate, I use Pest Now. And
that sounds like the wrong direction.
Okay. Well, they're the ones
Gone.
I'm just saying. I've used them forever. They've been a really, really good service. They've taken care of all my clients. But I was just curious if it was.
No, it's like I don't think they do that. Something. Oh, okay. I looked it up. They're out of Vegas.
Oh. Of course.
Yeah, that's why there's strippers. Because Victoria
traveling east.
Yeah, they're just sending strippers to the door, and then Brandon shows up, and the dude is literally shaking like the meth is wearing off, and I'm like, fantastic.
Hook, line, and sinker.
On a positive note, guys, you are standing in a pallet house that has been fumigated.
Love that for us.
Yeah.
Hmm. I feel safer.
I do too.
I feel very reassured.
The mesothelioma is setting in.
I was wondering why both of the turtles were upside down in the tank.
You said one hadn't moved in a while.
we treated the turtles. They go, hey, your contract includes turtle removal too. I was like, oh,
you want us to get rid of these?
Yeah, that's sweet. That's sweet. Oh, thanks, God.
Found these two parasites in your bar back there.
Your fish tank's overrun with turtles.
Fucking reptiles in your fish tank, bro?
Not anymore.
You got to get rid of those.
It's clean.
They're vicious.
It's an extra $300 we're going to bill you.
So,
what's he like for an extra $100? We'll do something else for you personally.
Pray tell, Stu.
I don't know. He was the one saying the nails were going to rub your head.
Yeah, that was a joke, Stu. What are you getting at?
What you were talking about. You're all over
objection,
it.
Objection, hearsay.
He allegedly said.
Allegedly.
I was just saying that Brandon wasn't as hot as Victoria. That's literally was my whole point. But in my mind, I'm like, I've done a good thing. I called my wife. I was like, hey, baby, I got rid of all those bugs. I got rid of the mice. I got rid of everything.
It's only going to cost us $17,000 over the next year.
And she's not going to pay for it.
Brendan's like,
my personal credit card is tied to it. Every 2 months, be
150. What'd you say his name was? Brandon?
Brandon.
Brendan's like, Brandon, not for nothing, but is Victoria coming back next time, baby? Yeah, yeah.
Really so she doesn't that, yeah, cause so see her more.
She was wearing.
I saw the boots. She was
those looked OSHA approved.
Yeah, like what the hell is this?
You're I'm, all, sure, I'm asking for a friend.
I'm sure she could wear a Tyvek suit if she had to.
Yeah, you're all sweaty and way too thin.
Very methy.
Very methy.
You had the perfect set of circumstances to not make a right decision.
Yeah, that
you're
does
about
suck.
To shit yourself. No. And there's a beautiful woman in front of you.
And,
you're
and like, you have actual pests.
Yeah.
No, and I literally have a call that is starting in fucking 5 minutes when we're getting to the close. And I'm like, I got to wipe my ass.
Let me do no research on this.
And then, I didn't even just watch TikTok.
Yeah.
This company has a one on Angie's list.
And then when we were done, she went to shake my hand. And I'm like, I know for a fact, I just wiped my ass and have not had a chance to wash my hand. And she sticks her hand out. And I was like,
you don't want to do that, ma'am.
You got what I got. I just shook her hand. Deal closed. And I ran inside and got on my call. So now she's got pink eye and I've got a 2-year contract.
So you signed things there, or was it an email later?
Oh, when I checked my email, like 2 hours later after my meetings, like all of a sudden my email was in there and it was like, reply yes, confirm. And I was like, oh, yeah, but fucking yes, get the fuck over here, dude. Like, I already told my wife I did a good thing.
There you go.
It's only $1,800 you're out. You're good.
Is that what it comes down to?
If it's $150 every 2 months.
Every 2 months for only 2 years.
Yeah. $1,800, $900 a year.
If I see one fucking silverfish, so help me God.
So I'm saying, you gotta get them on speed dial. Get them over here all the time.
Oh, I'll make
a weekly visit.
Hell yeah!
I promise you. Once I give my wife the number, they will fire us before the end of that 2-year contract.
There you go.
That is how every mosquito company. I've been through Mosquito Joe.
That's gonna be your out.
Mosquito Authority.
How many different mosquito companies are there around town? I feel like you gotta be. Are you gonna go back to like whatever the first one is and work your way through again?
I was a Mosquito Joe guy.
Okay.
I was a veteran owned. Like, I met the dude who owned it. He came out. I was like, I love Mosquito Joe. And then he kept calling. She kept calling him and calling him.
This is Brandon calling. Definitely not Brandon. Sound like that guy, Brandon. But this is Brandon.
When that dude showed up, he did not have PTSD. He'd made it through every war. When he left, he was shaking.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This woman.
No, every year, there's a new sign that gets planted every, like, 3 weeks in our yard. And I'm like, who is this going? Right now, we have one. It's like mosquito spot, and there's, like, a dog on it. And it's like, we're at the bottom of the barrel of mosquito companies right now. I even asked them, I was like, you guys do mosquitoes? They're like, no. I was like, damn.
Shit.
I could have had you guys this contract. Good luck. Good luck.
Jeez.
Sucker.
It's horrible, but it was the perfect confluence of events, you know?
I can't. Yeah, if only you could have just closed your door and walked away.
If only they'd rang the doorbell when I was still in
the
car.
If only it wasn't a dime.
Oh, yeah.
It was like an eight.
An eight.
The yoga pants and the boots, I'd never seen that combination. I was like, what is this? You're not working out. You're also not working. I don't know what I'm dealing with. It threw me for a loop. That threw me.
She knew what she was doing.
Signing contracts.
You need to talk to your neighbors. You need to talk to your neighbors and find out who else signed up.
Yeah. What other husbands were home?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Every dad who was at home that day is like, oh, I see the echo whatever truck stopping by all these houses.
This fall, you'll be standing out there at the bus stop, like kicking rocks together and being like, all right.
I asked.
You guys meet Victoria?
I asked Brandon. I said, how many of these sales do you get? And he's like, I literally only do same day sales. And he's like, I'm busy all week.
Wow.
Like, all the time. And I was like, so the sales force that good? He's like, man, it's shocking. It's shocking how many
people.
So
we've learned something. Beautiful young ladies can sell things.
But is this
we did
news,
not know this.
News to me.
But is this a one-off, like he's the owner and the guy that does the work, and that lady just works for him, or is there a bigger company?
Probably his girlfriend.
No, this dude, ew. No.
I really made Brendan upset. Like just the thought of that ruined. Like now he's really mad. He signed that contract. He's pissed.
You just put a shit vision in my
mind. That's right.
No. It took me back to a place. This is the most disgusting thing I'd ever seen. Boy, we're going to go down a tangent now. So I'm in Amsterdam.
And all of our favorites.
There's this place called the White Elephant. The White Elephant.
Yes.
Apparently has live sex shows.
Nice.
So every time I'm walking down the street.
Not dead sex shows?
Nope.
Okay.
So I'm walking
We're
down.
A pro-necrophilia podcast, Troy.
Never been to Amsterdam. I don't know how they do it.
I saw some weird shit in Amsterdam, but there's this place, the White Elephant, right? And like, as we're walking down the street, these guys are always like, live sex show, which is better than the guys on the corner who are like, ecstasy, speed, crack cocaine.
Nice.
Like they're just like selling, what was it? Ecstasy, speed, cocaine. Those are the things that, I literally saw these dude deal like packets out of their pocket. The packets are exactly the same.
Yes.
Ecstasy, speed, cocaine in Amsterdam. Is whatever they decide to hand you. And I'm sure it's whatever hooks you the most.
Whatever baby laxative they have.
Yeah, it was crazy. But these other guys were like, live sex show, white elephant, like just handing out stuff. And for days we were able to resist. Days, I tell you.
72 hours, tops.
A while.
Yeah. Like, we're not.
It wasn't 11 days.
Hours. But you get to a point.
I haven't had a beer in forever.
11 days.
We didn't go see the live sex show for
days.
For weeks.
6 hours.
Yeah. We hadn't checked into the hotel yet.
Man, I still have my luggage. I hadn't even made it to the fucking airport yet.
We can't check in until 4, guys. We might as well kill time.
Live sex show. Let's go.
That was basically, like, you get to a point where you're just walking around Amsterdam.
Between the airport and the hotel, yeah.
So he's
they're just like, oh, the White Elephant again. We keep circling back around here. Somebody giving us bad directions.
They just keep pumping the live sex show, right?
No pun intended.
So finally, we just give up, and because at one point the guy goes, hey man, look, it's free, and we'll give you a free drink, and I'm like, well, this is literally too good to pass.
There's
up.
A sucker born every time Brendan walks into a room.
And I know, want to know that dude's name?
Yeah.
Give you a guess.
Brandon.
Boom. Hate that guy. He makes horrible decisions for me. It's my alter ego.
So, yeah,
I was going to say, that's exactly what I was thinking.
So Brandon is like your evil nemesis, bizarro twin.
Yeah, who lives very close to me. So we decided to go into the White Elephant. That's what it was. We had to pay the cover, which was like $5, but they were going to give us a free drink.
Yeah.
So we're like, all right, well, it is a free drink. I could use a drink.
Sure.
So we go in there, and of course, because we're gaming the system.
Make I've got it all my a, luggage with me. I still need a drink.
Yep.
Make it a bourbon. You know? So, like, we walk in. They hand us our, like, bourbon and Cokes. And we go in, and it's like there's, like, this round stage sitting there. And there's a bed on it. And then fucking there's, like, bench seating all around. Sticky, sticky bench seating. And we sit down and we're sipping our bourbon and Cokes like, what the hell is going to happen here?
When's the fucking start?
And then this woman walks out and she lays down and this emaciated dude in work boots comes out just naked. I'm like, what the fuck? And so when you said Brandon banging her, this is exactly the image that popped into my head was this horrible experience, right? So this dude comes walking in these work boots. He never takes his work boots off. They're like Timberland high tops.
He needs grip.
So it really did take you back to a place.
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
He's got these Timberland high tops with no laces. And he walks in and like he somehow gets hard like immediately. And I'm like, impressive.
He bought ecstasy, some of those
cocaine.
Drugs.
Yeah.
And so this girl just lays there with like the most defeated look in the world on her face. And he
like
just
maybe she didn't want to be there.
Dude, he didn't want to be there. It was the weirdest thing. I never seen two people so unattracted to each other in my life. And she lays there, and then he just starts pounding. And they do that for 30 seconds, like a fucking metronome. 30 seconds. Then she turns to this position. And then he just lazily bangs her. Another 30 seconds. She goes to another position. He lazily bangs her. They do this for about 3 minutes. And then he's like, all right. He pulls out. There is no finish. There's no nothing. It was like two like heroin addicts.
Are you supposed to tip?
He did.
And then they both walk, get up like defeated looking and walk off the stage. And we look at each other like,
That sounds like one of the saddest things you could ever see.
It really was. Yeah. It really was. Like it hurt my soul. I was like, I've lost something.
I have the weirdest boner right now. The saddest boner of my life.
I refuse to touch this. I flat out refuse.
And then like the people in there, they just all look like homeless people who are like, well, for $5, I could get a drink at the bar, or I could pay the $5 cover, get a drink here, and just watch these two heroin addicts that I'll meet under the bridge later. It was disturbing. But yes, when you conjured up Victoria and Brandon, that's
your thought.
It was horrible.
Now you get to live with it.
I could barely finish my drink.
I might have to go on 10 days of not drinking.
That's right.
No, we absolutely did not. All right, should I tell you a good story about Amsterdam?
Please.
This one's fun. So
haven't told it on here yet?
I don't know, the peep show one?
I don't recall it.
This one's fun. So maybe. There's these things. They're like these little like round like buildings that sit by the canals in the red light district. We were always like, what the hell is this thing, you know? So we go in one because, you know, you gotta know. God forbid it's weird. And like
he just accidentally stumbles onto these nude places. Weird. No accidental art museums. No accidental historic sites.
No culture.
Yeah. Just, oh, another new place. Weird. Oh, wow. Let's check it out.
Crazy.
While we're here.
Yeah.
Might as well.
Man, this route from the airport to the hotel is very circuitous.
I told you I saw Nelson Mandela in Amsterdam.
Yeah, between your new shows.
Had to fit him in, you know?
Oh, my God. Shit.
Tell us how you accidentally went in this building. You had no clue what it was. You know when you're walking through a city, you just go in buildings, you don't know what they are?
Yeah, well, Amsterdam, to his point, is a much different city.
Yeah.
And there the red light district.
There is debauchery around every corner.
Yes.
Yeah, but you still don't walk into random buildings. You don't know
what
they are.
There you do, though. They welcome. There they just, like, stand there and just, like, beckon
like,
you
come in.
They're the
come
sirens.
In.
They're just like...
Have you been?
But you know
really
what those
do.
Buildings are, is my point.
Kind of.
I mean, you look at it and you're like, this one's made out of brick. Sounds good.
The half-naked chicks asking me to come in. I think I know what goes on here.
Yeah.
All right.
Where do I read children's books to the homeless kids again?
That's the next building down. Okay. But you got to go through that one first to sign up. So.
I just left the soup kitchen,
For the record, I didn't go in any red lights. I didn't actually bang any whores. I just observed.
Yeah, because they
your
do
hero
the fucking window.
Hero status never ceases to be. I didn't bang the hooker in Amsterdam.
I didn't drink for 11 days.
I'm pretty awesome.
When's your canonization happening?
Soon enough.
Did you get the key to the city while you were there, hero?
Did you get to drive the best boat down the canals?
I saw Nelson Mandela.
Oh, that's right.
Was he at the same round building?
Yeah.
No.
That would have been great.
What a dick, dude. Just after the Anne Frank house, a very solemn moment, you fucking prick. Jeez.
So you walked into this random building again.
Random building.
Yeah.
Thought we were feeding puppies. Saving puppies.
Is this in the
children.
SPCA? Damn it. Tricked again.
So we walk in this building, and it's another round building. Round is the common theme of like, oops, go here.
This is the wrong.
It took me seven buildings to figure it out.
So we walk in, and you hand them some dollars, and they hand you some coins, right?
Hold on. 30 seconds. You walked in and there was just somebody with a handout and you just said like, well, I'll put money in their hand.
No.
Okay.
We wanted to see what these were. We knew they were peep shows.
Sure. Mm.
But we didn't understand what a peep show was. So we were like, let's find out what a peep show is, right?
So, we don't have these in America.
Yeah, we don't. I haven't seen them. I believe they were in Times Square at one point, like in the 70s.
They were.
You know, but so like I go in and it's the old trope. Like you walk into a booth, the door shuts behind you and it's, now you're in your own booth, and you put a whatever coin they're using in, and the screen comes up, and now again, there's a bed in the center of a room that I'm looking at, and this bed is turning, and it just turns, and there's this, like, cheerleader just laying there. She's playing with her tits and doing her thing, and I'm like, this is fantastic. Like, I could see why people get into this. This is far better than the heroin addicts banging on the thing, you know? So I'm like, cool. And she's turning, and I can just kind of see over her shoulders at her boobs. And I'm like, ah, boobs. Like, she's slowly turning, and, like, My screen goes down. I'm like, fuck that noise. And like, throw it in again. She keeps turning and she's doing her thing and she's like doing this stuff and she's like playing with herself and she comes around. And then I'm looking and I'm like, God bless. That is like the largest clit I've ever seen. Like,
oh no.
Really, really big.
Pronounced.
Very pronounced.
Wait, quick question. As you're looking in, can you see the other windows?
They have reflective.
So it's just like, one-way mirror.
Yeah, one-way mirror.
Okay.
Yeah. And so I'm like, huh, like a lot of clit. And then she like moves her clit to, or moves her labia to the side, right? Giant lips. And her penis was so big. Like I
could barely finish.
I mean, I was alarmed at how much bigger her penis was. Like, she was really well endowed for a woman with such great tits and cheerleader outfit and costume. And I'm like, holy shit. And I'm like, oh, and I come running out, right? Like,
so
I'm
you
like,
cleaned
nah.
up and then what? No,
so I run out and there's four of us in there, right? And three of us come running out at the same moment because we're in stalls right next to each other. When she dropped her giant dong out, we were like, oh, and we go running out. I'm not kidding. My one buddy was in there for five more minutes. He never left. And I know he had to keep just dropping coin. We were like, yo, dude, like, did you notice the size of her lips? Like,
maybe he's a boob guy. He's a boob
guy. But we kept being like, what's up? And he's like, I thought we had to like spend all the money. And we've always been like, sure, buddy.
Yeah.
That dude finally.
The group of friends who walk randomly into a round building.
God. That dude finally found what he's been looking for his whole life and decided, well, these are one-way mirrors.
Yep.
I can't wait till this podcast is over.
Oh, you want to know?
You want to know? Yeah, you do.
Because I know.
Oh, you think you know?
No, I know.
He knows who was on the trip.
I know who went on the trip.
Oh.
He's got it narrowed down.
three of other guys. Yeah.
There's only three guys.
You got a good guess?
He's got a 33% chance of getting it right.
It was Brendan.
I was going to say. So my friend, are you air quoting?
So Brandon stays in there, right?
Brandon with the bad decisions.
Brandon's a freak, dude.
Brandon's
going to
finish.
Shit.
I mean, he's
Brandon
a gamer.
Finishes what he starts.
Yeah, he does.
I'm not mad at Brandon.
No, that's what Brandon
I'm mad
does.
At Brandon. We just don't always agree.
Yeah, sometimes.
But I don't disagree.
That's right.
That's all I'm saying.
Brandon's up for new experiences. We know that.
Yeah.
It's just some coins, dude.
Here's Brandon. Here's Brandon.
Oh, no. Someone peed in my pants.
Nah, Brandon's
That's
cool.
not pee, Brandon.
It
so,
is now.
So how much money did he go through if you like? You had to think of being
I have no idea.
Like,
I have
for
no
five
idea.
Minutes of coins, if it was like 30 seconds, they keep
well,
the window
open?
They hadn't
even made it to the exchange bank yet, so
God
knows. Oh, no.
And Brandon's like, this is the fourth time you guys have tricked me to come in here.
That man can only hold out for so long.
Yeah, right.
You got me again?
Well, I got this pocket full of coins, so you know. I couldn't possibly use these anywhere else.
Surely these brown houses don't use the same coins. Yeah.
No.
This is a Dave and Buster's kind of situation. Yeah, I can take you to multiple places.
This coin's bent.
I pumped it so many times. Look at all the tickets.
Let's go shopping at the tchotchke station.
How the fuck did we get here?
Your buddy Brandon got you there.
Pest control and live strip or sex shows.
Yeah, but like I was trying to do like a reasonable show.
Yeah, we had lots of lists.
Yeah, that we didn't touch on.
Literally none.
And we have
pretty standard.
Good, we can,
do you think that
maybe next week?
Do you Exterminator.
Oh, cross that one off. Do you think the people that listen to this show think that we don't actually really write lists down?
I write a list down every
That's
single week.
Yeah.
Every single week. It's just unfortunately some shows go right off the rails.
Yeah,
those are the best ones.
Sometimes. Sometimes you end up getting. See, this is the kind of show that ends up haunting me years later because people be like. Hey, Brandon.
Yeah, seven bourbons in. Rattling the pocket around.
feel like sharing.
Why is that one hand always in your pocket with the loose change, Brandon?
Because that's the pocket with the hole in it.
That's right. Oh.
I can reach the gumballs. See, that was a tie back to the beer.
There you go. You're a pro.
That's what I do. Laser focus.
There you go.
You guys want to keep going, or do you want to cut it at 134?
I say we wrap it up. Unless you want to do a double.
On air.
A double? Literally 11 o'clock at night.
That's why I don't want to keep going.
Perfect. I understand.
We'll save the topics for next week.
Yeah, we'll do one tomorrow.
You know we keep doing these. Yeah. Like this.
I do want to recognize that Nectar Sunglasses does have a new coupon code out there.
Can't tell you what it is. I mean, we can tell you the word, but I don't know what it equates to.
Let's call it 25.
We'll go with 20.
Let's go 20. We can't be wrong.
Yeah.
We can't be wrong. Because we've had 20, 25, and 30.
Yeah.
I literally didn't have... He and I sat around. We ate a chicken. Drank a couple of drinks and like talked about how we got to do this. And he was like, damn it, the system's down. He couldn't do it. And so like we never got to that point. And he was like, well, just text me what the code is.
Brandon.
No, this is Brendan. Brendan does work. Brandon's a fucking degenerate. And so we do have a new coupon code, and that coupon code is Abacus.
That's right.
There you go.
You got to figure out how to spell it. No, it's A-B-A-C-U-S.
Yes.
But I feel like I forget that oftentimes, and then I Google it and make sure the image looks right.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yep, that's a Chinese adding machine. That's an abacus.
Confirmed.
It does look weird on paper. You're like, is it missing something here?
Because it looks so simple.
Yeah.
You're like, I'm sure there's just a lot like more math. Characters.
Just like a lot more simple
just
than
like just math. Just simple.
Yes. But that is the new coupon code for Nectar Sunglasses, and I'm excited to have it for sure. So head on over there, drop Abacus in the coupon code, and you will get a tremendous discount. What I missed?
Nothing. Right? Nothing.
Don't make me panic now.
Are you going to talk about how we're ending this? We're just going to...
It's the same way we've ended it every year at this time. Today is July 14th when we're recording. This will come out July 15th, but July 14th is a sacred day, at least for us. This is the day of the Sullivan Blue Letter.
Yep.
So we will go against all the Spotify's regulations and we will play something. They could pull us down, they could not, but
probably not.
They're not listening.
Just the Chinese.
So we got to finish this. We got to do all of our sound offs before we hit the play button.
I mean, no.
I'm not going to talk over Sullivan Ballou.
Yeah.
Talk
producing over on air.
Talk over Dear Sarah.
Never.
That was a pretty good podcast.
Yeah, right. Not doing it.
That's not going to do.
I have too much respect for Sullivan Ballou.
But we got to give a shout out to him. So thank you guys so much for tuning in, week out. If you haven't had a chance to head over to the Venmo, see, I'm going to start there.
There you go.
That's probably where we should start.
What's that?
What is that one,
damn
Brandon?
I can't get it right. I don't know if you listened to that. I was like, I don't know it.
Inside the Pout House.
Which adds up. That's a perfectly reasonable name. If you haven't had a chance to head over to Be Real, I'm apparently three friends shy of seeing stats. That's BP Kennedy 34 on Be Real.
Yep.
Love to hear from you.
Check us out.
Yes. And Troy, you want to give out your handle?
FTBAUER.
Boom. There it is. Stu, you want to give out your handle?
For
Be Real.
No, I don't even know where it is. Even listening.
No, I was.
So make attention.
It's something with a 74 at the end.
Yeah, it's really not that hard. It's that's going to take
you
way too long.
You can't remember.
How, sir, would you
Stuart 74.
STUART.
Yeah, the only way you spell it.
That is not how Stuart is spelled.
What?
Okay, fine. Find them yourself. If you haven't had a chance to send us any topics, you can do so on Gmail. That's insidetheballothouse@gmail.com. We'd love to hear what you're thinking about, what you're talking about. We'll be glad to talk about it. That's a lot of abouts.
Maybe.
Maybe. If you haven't had a chance to head over to the Facebook page, please do so. It's easy to find us. Just look up Inside the Ballot House Podcast. Find us there.
Keyword Brandon.
Keyword Brandon.
Yeah.
You get a 10% discount if you enter Brandon at Nectar Sunglasses and a 20-some% discount if you enter Abacus. Your choice.
That's good negotiation on your part.
Pick your sides. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll be talking to you next week. Cheers.
That was a pretty good podcast, don't you think?
Peace out.
A week before the Battle of Bull Run, Sullivan Ballou, a major in the 2nd Rhode Island Volunteers, wrote home to his wife in Smithfield.
July the 14th, 1861, Washington, D.C. Dear Sarah, the indications are very strong that we shall move in a few days, perhaps tomorrow. And lest I should not be able to write you again, I feel impelled to write a few lines that may fall under your eye when I am no more. I have no misgivings about or lack of confidence in the cause in which I am engaged, and my courage does not halt or falter. I know how American civilization now leans upon the triumph of the government, and how great a debt we owe to those who went before us through the blood and suffering of the Revolution. And I am willing, perfectly willing, to lay down all my joys in this life to help maintain this government and to pay that debt. Sarah, my love for you is deathless. It seems to bind me with mighty cables that nothing but omnipotence can break. And yet my love of country comes over me like a strong wind and bears me irresistibly with all those chains to the battlefield. The memory of all the blissful moments I've enjoyed with you come crowding over me, and I feel most deeply grateful to God and you that I've enjoyed them for so long. And how hard it is for me to give them up and burn to ashes the hopes of future years, when, God willing, we might still have lived and loved together and see our boys grown up to honorable manhood around us. If I do not return, my dear Sarah, never forget how much I loved you, nor that when my last breath escapes me on the battlefield, it will whisper your name. Forgive my many faults and the many pains I have caused you. How thoughtless, how foolish I have sometimes been. But oh, Sarah, if the dead can come back to this earth and flit unseen around those they love, I shall always be with you in the brightest day and the darkest night. Always. Always. And when the soft breeze fans your cheek, it shall be my breath, or the cool air, your throbbing temple. It shall be my spirit passing by. Sarah, do not mourn me dead. Think I am gone, and wait for me, for we shall meet again.
Sullivan Ballou was killed a week later at the first battle of Bull Run.